In part 12, I showed you the process involved in accurizing a rifle action. This process aligns the axis of all major components. With the rifle trued up, I was ready to move on to the next step. My stock is equipped with a full-length aluminum bedding block. This is supposed to create a superior mounting system for the rifle. However, everything I read says the number one way to improve precision is to bed your action. So I decided to see how stable my aluminum bedding block actually was.
You can see when I set the barreled action into the stock, we have a whole bunch of play forward and aft, and we've also got a lot of twisting motion that can happen, as well as it shifts, wiggles back and forth.
But the amount of play wasn't my biggest concern. What really concerned me was the lack of contact between the action and the bedding block. Two thin lines on either side of the action create the majority of the contact area. A close look at the recoil lug shows that it's only making minimal contact with its supporting surface. Even worse is the area of the rear tang. Here you can see that the main wear mark is high and off-center. I was now convinced that to achieve optimal precision, I would need to bed the action. Here's a basic list of the items I'll be using for this project. The majority of our time will be spent prepping the stock to accept the bedding compound.
So here we have our Remington 700 action set into the stock. So far all I've really done is marked off with tape at the rear tang here, right where it ends, where when the recoil lug is right full back, it's marked off how far back we want to mark that. And then I've also marked off at the front where I want the end of the bedding to show up. So we've pulled our action fully apart, cleaned it, it's fully disassembled. And then underneath you can see we have our aluminum bedding block in this area, which goes front to back, and actually there's a thin portion which goes all the way up to the front, and part of it recesses into the back of the handle. So I'm thinking what I need to do is take where the recoil lug hits here and just shave this back a little bit so that we can get some of the Devcon in behind there. And then I'm also going to shave into this area here and recess it down a little bit. I want to leave this area right here, this square area right behind the bolt, at that level so it has something to rest on, and then the rest I'm going to sort of give it a slope down so that we can put Devcon in there. So looking at the bottom side through where the magazine well is, this is the area right in here. You can see that there's this big gap where you could potentially have some more support in this area where it touches this bridge here. They've left it all completely open, so you can probably gain some more support there. And then right here, there's all this area, surface area here, that the magazine guide fits on this inside edge. And over here we could have all our epoxy to help support the action up against the side of the stock. So I'm going to be looking to fill in this gap with a slight little tapered edge that comes off square or just slightly back. Now what I've just done is created a block of tape that's going to rest right inside the barrel channel, nice and solidly. So that's going to be our front float point. The other float point is going to be the rear tang right at the back little quarter to half inch there. So it's going to be when this is all cleaned out, it's only going to be resting here and up front, and then we'll be using the screws to hold it straight up and down. So what I've done is chopped off the heads of two bolts that were the right thread pitch to get into the bottom of the action. These are going to be our guide pins that we're going to use to make sure that we're holding everything together nice and straight. So now that it's all ready to go, what we'll do is we'll align it up here. So once we flip it over, we can take our bottom metal,
with the spring removed, and this will all be taped up as well so that we don't get any Devcon on it, and glue it into place. That'll hold that in place. And then our screws are nice and centered right down the center of the bottom metal, and everything is exactly in the alignment we're going to want. Tape it together, let our glue set, and we should be good to go. The next step is to grind out the inside of your stock to create room for the bedding compound. This is the point of no return. Once you start removing material from the stock, you're committed to refilling that area with bedding compound. Although a Dremel will suffice, a die grinder with some carbide bits will make the job much quicker. To help shape and profile some of the inside surfaces, it's best to have some large hand files available. A set of mini files and sandpaper can help you get into the tighter corners. The goal here is to create a gap of approximately 1/8 to 3/16 of an inch all the way around the action.
So it actually cleaned out quite nice. You can see I've now increased the gap between the action and the stock to approximately 1/8 inch all the way down. So here you can see the recoil lug and how I've created extra space in behind it now so that it'll be able to sandwich the recoil lug in that cavity. Right in there.
Once we're happy with the profile, we want to thoroughly clean the area with brake cleaner to ensure there are no oils left behind.
We don't want the Devcon getting into any of these cavities, so what we're going to do is fill all these cavities up with some modeling clay, plasticine if you will, clay, whatever, something that will prevent the Devcon from going into those areas. One of the key steps here is to put masking tape onto our recoil lug. Actually, I'm going to double that up right away.
We want our recoil lug to be securely sandwiched inside the bedding compound. However, we don't want the lug to get mechanically locked inside the bedding compound. Therefore, the two layers of masking tape should give us the small amount of breathing room we need to remove the action from the stock.
Got it all filled in where I don't want the stuff to go. And anything that is overflow and excess, we can machine out later. Big thing is to also got a dam up front here to try and prevent it from just oozing way, way forward. That'll help stop it a little bit, make it easier to trim later. So next on the list, we use some Kiwi Neutral shoe polish. And just polish everything up. We don't want it to stick to. I've already actually gone over it all mostly. Just putting a little extra on some of the areas. Make sure we got some on our bolts as well in case it gets on there. We don't want it to get stuck. Bottom floor plate here. So just in case any gets on it, I filled it up as well. Don't want it to stick.
Everything up to this point has been preparation for the main step. With all the holes plugged and our release agent applied, we're ready to mix up the bedding compound. Once you start mixing the bedding compound, you don't want any distractions.
This is the point of no return.
Make sure that all the items you'll need for this step are within arm's reach.
Bring out more than you need, because there's nothing worse than realizing, oops, I didn't mix up enough, and I'm not going to fill in all of my cavities. Once we mix in the paste here, the other side, it gets quite thin, not quite that much. Now to mix it up. I always find that mixing these epoxies up is easier on a flat board where you can really mash it down, as opposed to mixing it up in a cup where you're really restricted and confined in the amount of space you have to work. I'm gonna fill in right where I want it all to go. Pack it in there, no air bubbles.
Most epoxies have a working time of 5 to 15 minutes. Quick application is key to creating a professional looking bedding job.
It's looking pretty good to me. I'll move that to the side. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take our action. We're actually going to put a little bit on all over the place to try and make sure we don't create any air bubbles when we seat this down. This is the moment of scariness. This is where we set her in there.
Applying compound to both sides of the project ensures 100% contact.
And hope.
If any air bubbles are created, they will be tiny and sandwiched in between the two layers.
Mop up some of that right now.
Cleaning off some of the excess now will save us a bunch of work down the road.
Grab it nice and tight, throw a bit over. We're going to clean this stuff out because we don't want too much in and around here. A lot of release onto my box as well. So there, we're lined up.
We only want to apply light pressure to the action while the Devcon sets up.
So now I'm going to wrap tape.
Using light hand pressure, we can wrap tape halfway between our two float points to create a stress-free bedding job.
Everything's happy. Now, been about 3 hours, so we're going to take a blade. We're just going to run along.
Trimming while the Devcon is still soft will help prevent mechanical lock.
Pull that out of there.
It will also help cut down the time required to machine the final product.
While it's still a little bit soft. So, drying time is complete. It's time for the moment of truth. Well, that dropped right out. Good, didn't glue it in.
The bedding has now set and created a perfect impression of our action.
Feeling it moving.
We don't want to damage our new bedding job, so you need to be careful when you're tapping out the action.
Here we go. She's free and clear. So when I busted it free, unfortunately there's a little bit that chipped out at the back here, but otherwise we got nice looking contact absolutely everywhere. Nice and perfectly round. And you can see that my magazine well is in there really tight right now too, but I put lube all over that as well, release agent. There we go.
The bedding compound is now ready to be machined. A die grinder and a good set of hand files will again make this job quick and easy. The idea here is to remove just enough material to give a nice clean look. We also need to take into consideration all the moving parts of the firearm. The trigger, safety, and bolt release all need to have enough room to function correctly. I also gave the upper surfaces a quick coat of flat black paint. I am really happy with the bedding job that was achieved. After a 7-day wait for the Devcon to 100% cure, the stock and action are ready for final assembly.